Welcome to the Craft Cave. Today I'll be showing you my process for how I painted these two Civil War miniatures. I picked these up at my local game store. If you're interested, this is the pack they came out of. Alright, so our first step here is to shave down all of the mold lines that were created in the process of molding these figures. Just use our hobby knife and gently go over all of the edges, making sure not to damage the miniature itself. Alright, the next thing we need to do is take this Rust-Oleum flat black primer, and we're just going to make sure to give those a nice even coat. Then our next step is to take the Rust-Oleum flat white primer and just hit those from the top to get our highlights. This is referred to as Zinthal priming. Just gives us a better guide later on where to add our highlights and shadows. And then we're finally on to painting. So today I'll be using the Master's Touch acrylic paints again, starting with the blues for this Union soldier. Then from here I'll take a darker blue and go into all the creases and folds of the fabric to create some shadows and contrast in the legs. Then next I'm going to be taking a few browns to get our different leather tones, making sure to change them up so they don't all look identical. Then on to creating the flesh tones. And next we're going to take some lighter blues and create some highlights on the legs. And from here, the majority of the model is painted. We're just going to go through and do some touch-up. And finally, we're going to add some highlights to the leather. Now we're going to take some much lighter blue and really add some contrast to the jacket. Now all we have to do for him is clean up his base, which we'll do after we paint the Confederate soldier, and he'll be ready to go. And with this one, we're just going to start with a nice gray base coat that we'll be able to build layers up with and down from. And next we're just going to use the same pigment that we used on the face and skin of the last miniature. And now we'll be taking a lighter gray and going through and adding our highlights to the pants and jacket. And here we have the final results of those two paint jobs. All we have left now to do is to paint the bases, and these will be finished up. And here we have the final product. Hope you all enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one.